morning dear students, welcome back to my today's class. So as I have started the fifth chapter of your syllabus, that is principle of inheritance and variations. In last class I have completed or I have started the last point of this chapter, that is genetic disorders. In that genetic disorders, I told you the two categories are there. One is the Mendelian disorders and another one is the chromosomal disorders. So in the last class we have completed the Mendelian disorders. Before going to see the chromosomal disorders, I will revise briefly about the Mendelian disorder. First of all, the genetic disorders means what? These are the disorders. So this is what the genetics in a human society is studied under a specialized branch, that is called as a human genetics. What is meant by human genetics? Human genetics means the study of inheritance of a characters in a humans. So how this character passes from parents to the offspring is called we'll study in this human genetics. So in the genetics, what as we do, we can tell that the characters which passes from parents to the offsprings. Okay, so this is called as the inheritance, or it is also called as the heredity. So not only the healthy character can passes from parents to the offsprings, as well as some of the what abnormalities also passes. Some of the diseases also passes from parents to the offsprings, and that diseases are called as what? The disorders, genetic disorders, which comes from the parents to offsprings. And these, whatever the disorder which comes from the parents to the offsprings, they can passes from one generation to the another generation. One by one generation, that diseases can be passes. So we have seen how they can passes with the help of what? The family tree, that is nothing but pedigree analysis. In that we have seen that how the affected parents can have the affected children, or how the unaffected parents can have the affected children. These are we have seen that through the pedigree analysis, that is schematic representation. Then in the genetic disorders, I told you that the two categories are there. One is the Mendelian disorders. So Mendelian disorders, in that what we have seen in Mendelian disorders, these are the due to what? Mutation. Mutation means already you know that the sudden change in the gene level. So it may be gene level, it may be chromosome level. So in the because of the mutation, the Mendelian disorders can occur. So this Mendelian disorder study is based on the principle which is proposed by the Mendel, that is principle of inheritance. So on this basis the Mendelian disorder study has been done. So in that I told you the many example, 5 to 6 name of the example I told you, but what I told you in your syllabus, only the 3 diseases have mentioned to see the symptoms and the characters. So what are that the 3 diseases, that is disorders, Mendelian disorders we have seen in the previous class. First we have seen that hemophilia, okay, and then next one is we have seen that the sickle cell anemia and phenylketonuria. So these we have seen because of what changes these disorders can come in the humans, that we have seen. And then next is the second category of the genetic disorder is what? Chromosomal disorder. So that we have to see in the today's class, and this is your last point of this chapter number 5, that is principle of inheritance and variations. So write down the heading, today's class heading, genetic disorders actually already we have started this in the previous class. One category we have completed, that is Mendelian disorder, and in today's class we will see the chromosomal disorder, that is second category. Chromosomal disorders. So this chromosomal disorders, as this Mendelian disorders is based on what? The mutation. Okay, then now this chromosomal disorder is because of what? The aneuploidy. Because of the aneuploidy. What is mean by aneuploidy? Already we have seen this definition. Aneuploidy means the addition or deletion of the set of the chromosome is called as the aneuploidy. So as this aneuploidy, in this aneuploidy what happens? The addition of chromosome about the particular chromosome number. So if we focus to the human, what is the chromosome number? That is 46 chromosomes are present in the human. And in that also I told you that the two parts are there. One is autosome, another one is the allosome. So autosomes means what? These are the body chromosomes, or also called as the somatic chromosomes. And the one set is the allosomes, which are called as the sex chromosome. So which define the sex of the human, that is male or the female. So this chromosomal disorders is due to the addition or deletion of a set of chromosome in a diploid set. Okay, so that is called as the aneuploidy. I'll write here. Aneuploidy, what is mean by this? Addition or deletion of chromosome number, or you can write it chromosomes, in a diploid set of chromosome. Is called as aneuploidy. Got the point here? Aneuploidy, because of aneuploidy, this chromosomal disorders can comes. And then what is mean by aneuploidy? The addition or deletion. So see, if one chromosome, extra chromosome is added, then also what? It is abnormality. If one chromosome is deleted, then this is also abnormality. So this addition or deletion of the chromosome, what occurs, and that is called as the aneuploidy. This is because of what? Disjunction of chromosome. This is due to the disjunction or non-separation of chromosomes. During gamete formation. Okay, so what it means, disjunction or the non-separation. So see, in the sexual reproduction, what happens? The gamete formation takes place. Male gamete develops and the female gamete develops. Then that gamete fuses. Then reproduction occurs. Then the offsprings are formed. These are the usual process that you know. Here what happens, this during the gamete formation because of the process of what? Meiosis. At that time what happens, in meiosis, again we have seen in detail the gamete formation, how it occurs. In first and second chapter we have seen the gamete formation. Okay. So during the gamete formation, whenever the stages will come, that is separation of chromosomes will come, at that time what happens? No separation of chromosome occurs, means non-separation of chromosome, or it may be because of the disjunction of the chromosome. If it is happens during the process of gametogenesis or gamete formation, then what happens? That leads to the aneuploidy, and aneuploidy results into the chromosomal disorders. What the point here? Chromosomal disorders meaning. Okay. And next is, we have to see aneuploidy, the types of aneuploidy. Okay. Following types of aneuploidy is there. Four types are there. Okay, first one is trisomy. Second one is monosomy. And third one is tetrasomy, and the last one is the nullisomy. Okay, so these are the types of aneuploidy based on what? Addition of a set of chromosome number or deletion of the chromosome number. As I told you, the definition is addition or deletion of a chromosome in a diploid set. Okay, diploid set. Diploid means which we can write by the 2n. So this trisomy means what? This diploid set of chromosome is there. If one chromosome is added in this, means 2n plus 1. So it what happens? addition of one chromosome in a diploid set is called as a trisomy. Then monosomy means, again here the diploid set of chromosome number, monosomy means the deletion of one chromosome from the diploid set. What is monosomy? The deletion of one chromosome from diploid set is called as the monosomy. And then next is a tetrasomy means, in a diploid set of chromosome, the two chromosomes are added. Means here the definition of tetrasomy is the addition of two chromosome in a diploid set is called as the tetrasomy. Means 2 plus 2 it becomes 4. Okay, here 2 plus 1 becomes 3, so it is trisomy. Monosomy means 2 minus 1 means mono, single, monosomy. Like this you have to remember. The last one is the nullisomy. Nullisomy means in a diploid set of chromosome, the two chromosomes are deleted. Okay, so the definition of nullisomy is the deletion of two chromosomes from diploid set is called as the nullisomy. See, 2 minus 2 means it becomes 0. So 0 means what? Nullisomy. So these are the following types of the aneuploidy based on the addition and deletion of the number of chromosomes. I think you might have understood this. Okay. So the question may be asked, what is chromosomal disorders? Define trisomy, tetrasomy, monosomy, nullisomy for 1-1 marks. This question may be asked. So in this Mendelian disorders, how we have seen some of the examples, some of the disorders along with their symptoms and the characters. Similarly, in the this chromosomal disorder, we have to see some of the examples, what are the characters and what are the symptoms we have to see. So, in this chromosomal disorder, first we will see the disease, that is the Down syndrome. Firstly, we will see the Down syndrome. The first chromosomal disorder is the right here. Down syndrome. This Down syndrome is also called as mongolism. It is the another name for the Down syndrome, that is mongolism. So this Down syndrome is also called as hyperautosomal syndrome. Hyperautosomal syndrome. Just remember the point. Down syndrome. First type of this chromosomal disorder, the Down syndrome, which is also called as mongolism, and this is also known by the other name, that is hyperautosomal syndrome, or you can write it as a disorder. Okay. Then next, first we'll see how this Down syndrome is discovered, and it is discovered by the which scientist. Okay. So first of all, right, this Down syndrome is firstly reported by the scientist whose name is, that is, he is a physicist, okay, British physician. British physician. And his name is Langdon Down. Langdon. Okay, you can see here the name of this British physician is the Langdon Down. So Langdon is the first name, Down is the second name. So the syndrome name or the disease name is what? By his second name of the scientist. So this Down syndrome, it can be occurs in a children, out of the 1000 children, it can occur to a single child. So usually this Down syndrome can occur. It can see in this incident is seen in the child who is born from the old mother. Okay, I'll write here. occurs among the thousand children. One case, okay, remember one case. And next is this incident can occur in a child born from old mother. Got the point? Means here the mother who is older in age and she can be gives a birth to the child, so that child may be abnormal by this disease, that is Down syndrome. And this Down syndrome can occur in a children, means among the thousand children, the one case we can see. So how this Down syndrome can be occurs? This is the example of, this Down syndrome is the example of trisomy. And this is called as what? Autosomal disorder. I have written here autosomal. Autosomal means this, whatever the changes of chromosomes are there, that changes occurs at the autosomes, that is body chromosomes. So the changes can occur, the addition of one chromosome in the 21st pair of the chromosome. And right here, addition of one chromosome at 21st pair of chromosome. So you can see in a diploid set of chromosome, what happens? A diploid set of chromosome, one chromosome is added. So that is in the 21st number of the chromosome, one chromosome is the added. So this is what? Trisomy. So how the chromosome number will be? See, actually in the human, totally how many chromosomes are there? 46 chromosomes are there. Among that, the 44 are the autosomes and 2 are the allosomes, that is sex chromosomes. Okay, I'll write here 44 autosomes plus XX and 44 autosomes plus XY. So already you know this is female and this is male. Okay, so this is the set of chromosome to the normal person. Okay, and see the person who has suffering from the Down syndrome. Down syndrome. What happens here? 45 autosomes, means one chromosome is added in the autosomes, plus XX and 45 autosome plus XY. This is the condition in the female and this is the condition in the male child. Got the point here? Down syndrome means here the addition of one chromosome at the 21st pair of the chromosome. That is 45 autosomes are there instead of 44 and the sex chromosomes are as it is. Okay. So these, whatever this addition of chromosome takes place, this is because of what? Because of the non-separation or non-disjunction of the chromosomes at the time of gamete formation in old female. Got the point? So these Down syndromes can occur because of what? The female who is older in age and at the time of gamete formation, this addition of chromosome takes place. Means particularly the non-separation of chromosome occurs at the time of gamete formation. So these are what? The brief characters how this disease can come. And then now next we have to see what are the symptoms of this Down syndrome. Okay. So what the point I have written on the board, you have to write in your notebook. And by that you can remember the symptoms. In examination, the question may be asked on each of these diseases or these disorders or syndrome. That is, write a note on Down syndrome or what is the Down syndrome. Write the symptoms. Like this, the question may be asked. Now we have to see the symptoms of Down syndrome. Okay. So what are the symptoms? One by one, we'll see. So the persons who have been suffering from this Down syndrome, they are short stature. This is the first symptom. Next one is they have small and slant eyeballs. And next is they have enlarged the forehead. Okay, and next one is they have flattered nose. Next, that person's how means they have swollen lips and tongue. Okay, and next they have stubby fingers and spongy toes. What the symptoms I told you? They are short stature. They have small and the slant eyeballs. And next, they have enlarged foreheads. They have flattened nose. And next, they have swollen lips and tongue. And they have stubby fingers and the spongy toes. Again, these persons have low IQ. So these are the symptoms which we can see in the Down syndrome persons. Once again, I repeat, they are short stature. So short stature means their height. So in the height, they have the shorter height. And the next one is they have small and slant eyeballs. Their eyeballs are very smaller. And the next one is they have enlarged forehead. So as compared to the normal person, this forehead of this infected persons have what? The large, okay, enlarged forehead. Next one is they have the flattened nose and they have swollen lips and tongues. And next, they have stubby fingers. Stubby fingers means here they have the shorter fingers and also they have the spongy toes. Means it is like a filled with like sponge. It looks like yellowish. So that is what the fingers of that person are, the stubby and the spongy toes. Okay, and then they have the low IQ. And also one more symptoms we can see, they have slugging and salivating mouth. So this slugging means what? Like it is this mouth is like looking like a downwardsly. And then salivating means what? Always these persons, from the mouth of these persons, the saliva will come out. Okay, so these are the symptoms of the Down syndrome we have seen. And the next one is similarly we have to see the two more chromosomal disorders. The next one is the Klinefelter syndrome and the third one is the Turner syndrome that we have to see. I think you have understood this Down syndrome. Very easy it is. Only the thing is you have to remember the characters and the symptoms of each disorder. First chromosomal disorder we have seen, that is the Down syndrome. Next we have to see the second one is Klinefelter syndrome. Klinefelter syndrome. Okay. It is also called as hyperallosomal aneuploidy. Got the point? They have written hyperautosomal. Autosomal means the changes has been occurred in the autosomal chromosomes. Here I have mentioned the allosomal. Allosomal means, just remember, the changes of the chromosome takes place in the sex chromosome, that is the allosomes. Okay. So this Klinefelter, first of all, it is discovered by the scientist whose name is Harry Klinefelter. Okay, Harry Klinefelter. You can see first name is Harry and the second name is the Klinefelter. So by his name only the name of the syndrome is there. So similarly, Langerhans means the Down disease is what? Because of the scientist, proposed by the scientist whose name is the Langerhans. By his second name only the name of the syndrome is there. Here also the same. By his second name of the scientist, the syndrome name is there. So as I told you, here it is a hyperallosomal aneuploidy. Aneuploidy. So this is what? This Klinefelter syndrome is also a trisomy. Which kind of aneuploidy it is? Trisomy. So as you know that trisomy means the addition of one chromosome at the diploid set of chromosome is called as the trisomy. So Down syndrome also trisomy. But what the difference is there? Here the addition of one X chromosome takes place. Okay. Addition of X chromosome. So X chromosomes means what, you know? These are the what? Allosomes, which defines the sex of chromosome. Already you know that the male has the XY chromosome and the female have the XX chromosome. So in this Klinefelter syndrome, what happens? The addition of one chromosome, that is X chromosome, is added. So totally the chromosome number is what? 46. Addition of one chromosome takes place, which what happens? It becomes 47. So how it becomes 47? Totally 44 are autosomes and 2 are the allosomes. I'll write here autosomes. Okay. And this is what, one addition of chromosome takes place. Remember the one thing is, this Klinefelter syndrome we can see in the man. Okay. In the male we can observe this syndrome. So here what happens? Addition of one chromosome. Actually the chromosome in male, what the chromosomes are present? Only XY. But here the addition of one chromosome takes place, so it becomes 2X and Y. So the total chromosome number is what? 47. How many? 44 are the allosomes and 3 are the sex chromosomes. So usually the sex chromosomes are only 2. But here addition of one chromosome takes place, so this is the abnormality and that leads to what? The trisomy, and which results into the Klinefelter syndrome. And the next one is, this usually I told you what? Occurs in male. So this what? Trisomy. I told you that trisomy means addition of one X chromosome takes place in a diploid cell. So what number it becomes? 2N plus 1. That is trisomy. And then this is what? Totally 44 autosomes are there and 3 sex chromosomes. Total number of chromosome is the 47. And I told you this occurs in a male and which can be called as a sterile male. Sterile male. Okay. And then these are the characters we have seen. Now we have to see the symptoms of this Klinefelter syndrome. What are the symptoms? We'll see. Symptoms. Okay, the first symptom of this Klinefelter syndrome is they are tall stature. They are tall stature. Next is the body shows obesity. Body shows obesity. Then third one is scanty hair on body. Scanty hairs on the body. Next is they shows tendency towards female. For example, like what? Enlarged chest. Next, they have underdeveloped testis and no production of androgen. No production of androgen. Also, no production of sperms. So they are sterile. Okay, so these are the following symptoms which we can observe in the Klinefelter syndrome. So as I told you here, the addition of one set of the X chromosome takes place, and usually this Klinefelter syndrome can occur in the male. And then here, what are the symptoms? First of all, they are the tall stature. So the height of these persons are what? They are the tall stature. And then next, the body shows obesity. And then next, scanty hairs on the body. So large number of and the thick hairs are present. And then they show a tendency towards the female. It means what? Because of the addition of one X chromosome, that is one extra X chromosome, these are the male which shows what? Some of the female characters. Okay, for example, the female character, the enlarged chest is present in such persons. So remember, this Klinefelter syndrome, usually we can observe this in the man, that is male. Next, that persons have the underdeveloped testis. So as you know that the testis is the reproductive part of the male, and this is what completely the testis are not developed. And because of this underdeveloped testis, and there will be no production of the androgen. So you know that the androgen is nothing but what? It is the hormone. And next is no production of sperm. So as you know that the testis is the reproductive structure of the male, and this sperm is the what? The gamete of the male. So as these testes are not developed, then what happens? No production of sperms. So if the sperms are not produced, then such males are called as the sterile male. So they are called as sterile male. What it means? These are the persons who are unable to reproduce the new offsprings. Means they cannot take part in the reproduction. So such persons are called as what? The sterile male. So these all the symptoms we can see because of what? Because of addition of one X chromosome. That is, it leads to the syndrome, and that is the name of syndrome is the Klinefelter syndrome, which is also called by the another name hyperautosomal aneuploidy. Okay, I think you have understood. So this is the second chromosomal disorder. Next, we have to see the third example, and that is the last example. That is Turner syndrome. Okay, so this Turner syndrome is like exactly opposite to this Klinefelter syndrome. In Klinefelter syndrome, one X chromosome is added. In Turner syndrome, one X chromosome is deleted. The last and the third one is, we'll see the Turner syndrome. Turner syndrome. And which is also known by another name, it is the hypoallosomal aneuploidy. Okay, so this is the hypoallosomal aneuploidy. And then this Turner syndrome, how these two syndrome down and the Klinefelter syndrome is discovered by the scientist. Similarly, this Turner syndrome is discovered by one of the scientists, and whose name is the Henry Turner. So this syndrome name is also by the second name of the scientist. Turner, Henry is the first name and this Turner is the second name. By his name only the syndrome name is there. So as I told you, this Klinefelter syndrome, in that addition of one set of chromosome takes place, and usually this we can see in the man, okay, that is in the male. This Turner syndrome is because of what? The deletion of one chromosome. How the Klinefelter syndrome is the addition of one X chromosome, similarly here the Turner syndrome is due to the deletion of one chromosome. And Klinefelter syndrome is the example for trisomy, and this Turner syndrome is the example for monosomy. So I'll write here, it is due to deletion of one X chromosome, and that is nothing but what here, 2N-1. So it is called as what? Monosomy. Example for monosomy. You can see this is also called as a hypoallosomal. Allosomal means, you know that this is the sex chromosome. So the changes, what the changes has occurred, that is towards the level of the sex chromosome. So it is due to what? The deletion of one X chromosome, and this Turner syndrome usually we can observe in the female. So totally the diploid set of chromosome, if in that one X chromosome is deleted, and that leads to what? Monosomy. Already know that monosomy means 2N-1. So this is what usually occurs in the female, and which are called as the sterile female, which are unable to reproduce. Understood? So what the chromosome will become here? Totally the 44 allosomes are present. It is what? Correctly, it is normal. And then the changes has been done at towards the allosome. 1X chromosome deleted means remain only 1X. So already you know that the female has 2X chromosome. 1X chromosome is deleted. So what remains? 1X chromosome, and it is 0. Means here one chromosome is deleted. So the arrangement of chromosome is like this. 44 allosomes is there and 1X chromosome. And these females can be known as the name sterile female. And here these females cannot be reproduced. So this is about the characters of the Turner syndrome. We have to see what are the symptoms of this Turner syndrome. Okay, symptoms. small stature. Next, they have webbed neck. Webbed neck. And then they do not attain puberty. Do not attain puberty. Then next is enlarged breast, enlarged chest. Next we can see here underdeveloped breast, Next, these are occurring in the female, so the changes has been occurs in the female. And next here, underdeveloped ovaries, means they are not completely developed. And next, they do not produce ovum or egg, so they are sterile. And in such females, no menstruation or no menstrual cycle. Okay, so these are the following symptoms, and what are that? We'll see. So first of all, they are small stature. Next, they have webbed neck and they do not attain puberty. So first I will tell you webbed neck. Webbed neck means what? In such persons, the persons which are affected by this Turner syndrome, here the neck, so this region, the skin is what? The loose skin will be gross, and that is connect to the shoulders. Downwardsly it will be grow, and this neck, completely the skin of neck is connected to the shoulders. So that is called as a webbed neck. Such persons have the webbed neck. And then they do not attain puberty. So as you know that, and particularly the male and female, when they will reach to the particular age, the changes has been occurs, means the secondary sexual characters can be developed. Then these are the persons, these are the females who got this Turner syndrome, they cannot attain the puberty. Means the secondary sexual characters cannot develop in such females. And what are that? We have to see. And then such persons have the large chest also is there, that is what, enlarged chest. And then next one is underdeveloped breast. So this breast, the development of breast is also a secondary sexual character, but in such females the chest is not developed, so that is called as what, the underdeveloped breast it is. And next one is the underdeveloped ovary. So as you know that the female reproductive structure, so they possess the ovary. And then here underdeveloped ovary means the ovaries are not completely developed. So because of this underdeveloped ovary, such females do not produce the ovum or egg. So as you know, the ovum and egg is nothing but the female gametes. So because of the underdeveloped ovary, they are unable to produce the egg or the ovum. And such females are called as the sterile female. They are the sterile female. Next, no menstruation or no menstrual cycle. So as they cannot attain the puberty, these females cannot attain the puberty. So what happens? No menstruation takes place. Already you know that it is a reproductive cycle. Menstrual cycle means it is a reproductive cycle which occurs in the every month in the females. So because of this, they do not attain puberty. Their menstrual cycle cannot be occur. So this Turner syndrome is what? Because of the absence or the deletion of one X chromosome. So it is the allosomal disorder. Got the point? So by this point, we'll complete your chapter number 5, that is principle of inheritance and variations. I think you have understood this. This chapter is too much lengthy it is, and very important part from your syllabus. So this chapter is what? Minimum 10 marks or 12 marks questions will come from this chapter. So whenever I taught you each and every concepts, I told you how the questions will come and what the answer you should write. Okay, but again after this class, once again what I will do, after the completion of the syllabus, I will revise this chapter and as well as we'll discuss some important question and answer in that classes. I think you have understood this class. If you have not understood, you can ask me the questions. Okay. So, by this I completed the genetics topic. So, I just tell you that you have to study well. Okay. And then, thank you for today's class. Until that, stay home, stay safe.